Of course, there is no question that Libya and the world would be better off with Gaddafi out of power. I, along with many other world leaders, have embraced that goal and will actively pursue it through non-military means. But broadening our military mission to include regime change would be a mistake. The task that I assigned our forces to protect the Libyan people from immediate danger and to establish a no-fly zone carries with it a UN mandate and international support. It's also what the Libyan opposition asked us to do. If we tried to overthrow Gaddafi by force, our coalition would splinter. We would likely have to put U.S. troops on the ground to accomplish that mission, or risk killing many civilians from the air. The dangers faced by our men and women in uniform would be far greater. So would the costs and our share of the responsibility for what comes next. To be blunt, we went down that road in Iraq. Thanks to the extraordinary sacrifices of our troops and the determination of our diplomats, we are hopeful about Iraq's future. But regime change there took 8 years, thousands of American and Iraqi lives, and nearly $1 trillion. That is not something we can afford to repeat in Libya.